sound. Play with the rabbit ears.
Reports, incredible as they seem, are not the results of mass hysteria.
Mass hysteria. What do they think? We're imagining all this?
Shut up!
In all parts of the country, the wave of murder which is sweeping the eastern third of the nation is being committed by creatures who feast upon the flesh of their victims. First eyewitness accounts of this grisly development came from people who were understandably frightened and almost incoherent. Officials and newsmen at first discounted those eyewitness descriptions as being beyond belief. However, the reports persisted. The medical examinations of some of the victims bore out the fact that they had been partially devoured. I think we have some late word of just arriving, and I'll interrupt to bring this to you. This is the latest disclosure in a report from National Civil Defense Headquarters in Washington. It has been established that persons who have recently died have been returning to life and committing acts of murder. A widespread investigation of reports from funeral homes, morgues, and hospitals has concluded that the unburied dead are coming back to life and seeking human victims. It's hard for us here to believe what we're reporting to you, but it does seem to be a fact. When this emergency first began, radio and television was advising people to stay inside, behind locked doors, for safety. Well, that situation has now changed, and we're able to report a definite course of action for you. Civil defense machinery has been organized to provide rescue stations with food, shelter, medical treatment, and protection by armed National Guardsmen. Stay tuned to the broadcasting stations in your local area for this list of rescue stations. This list will be repeated throughout our news coverage. Look for the name of the rescue station nearest you and make your way to that location as soon as possible.
So we have that truck. If we can get some gas, we can get out of here.
There's a pump out by the shed.
I know, that's why I pulled in here, but it's locked.
Called this afternoon by the president. Since convening this conference of the presidential cabinet, the FBI, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, the CIA, has not produced any public information. Why are space experts being consulted about an earthbound emergency? Well, so far, all the betting on the answer to that question centers on the recent Explorer satellite shot to Venus. That satellite, you'll recall, started back to Earth, but never got here. That's the space vehicle which orbited Venus and then was purposely destroyed by NASA when scientists discovered it was carrying a mysterious high-level radiation with it. Could that radiation be somehow responsible for the wholesale murders we're now suffering? Newsman Don Quinn in Washington has posed those questions.
It's obvious our best move is to try to get out of here.
How are you going to get over to that pump? Look!
You're coming from a meeting regarding the explosion of the Venus probe, is that right?
Yes, that was the subject of the meeting.
You feel there is a connection between this and the phenomenon?
There's a definite connection. A definite connection.
In other words, you feel that the radiation on the Venus probe is enough to cause these mutations?
There was a very high degree of radiation.
Well, just a minute. I'm not sure that that's certain at all. I don't think that has been
the only logical explanation that we have at this time.
In other words, it is the military's viewpoint that the radiation is not the cause of the mutation.
I can't speak for the entire military at this time, gentlemen. I must disagree with these gentlemen presently until this is irrefutably proved.
Everything is being done that can be done.
We'll have to hurry for our next meeting.
Professor, you feel that there is a definite connection between...
connection as far as Dr. Keller and myself.
Doctor, please. I thought we decided that is not proved yet.
When the satellite was exploded...
An unusual amount of radiation, enough to cause mutation under certain circumstances.
Could have happened to have a bearing on it.
It does seem to have a bearing. Yes.
Will there be a reply for this?
Later.
Yes.
There will be a reply.
Yes.
Later this afternoon. There will be a report this afternoon.
Perhaps there will be a report.
Will you close the window? We are doing everything possible to solve the problem.
For NASA, Dr. Grimes, your entire staff, I know, has been working very hard to find some solution to these things that are happening. Do you have any answers at this time?
Yes, we have some answers. But first, let me stress the importance of seeking medical attention for anyone who's been injured in any way. We don't know yet what complications might result from such injuries.
How bad has your kid been hurt?
Good advice, Doctor. Now, how about the basic problem of patients?
Well, look, you go down there and tell... And Judy? Yeah, you tell Judy to come up here and you stay with the kid, all right?
...action taken with regard to the Venus probe. In the cold room at the university, we had a cadaver. Cadaver from which all four limbs had been amputated. Sometime early this morning, it opened its eyes and began to move its trunk. It was dead, but it opened its eyes and tried to move. The body should be disposed of at once, preferably by cremation.
Well, how long after death, then, does the body become reactivated?
It's only a matter of minutes.
Minutes? Well, that doesn't give people time to make any arrangements.
No, you're right. It doesn't give them time to make funeral arrangements. The bodies must be carried to the street and burned. They must be burned immediately. Soak them with gasoline and burn them. The bereaved will have to forego the dubious comforts that a funeral service will give. They're just dead flesh and dangerous.
I see.
Judy, I need you to find some bedspreads or sheets to tear up into small strips, okay? Is there a fruit cellar here?
Yes.
We need some bottles or jars to make Molotov cocktails and hold them off while we try to escape.
Hey, there's a big can of kerosene down there.
I'll see what I can find.
I'll look for the bottles. There's a big key ring down there. There may be a key to the gas pump on it.
I'll check.
We can toss the cocktails from a window upstairs. In the meantime, a couple of us can go out and try to get the gas and come back for the rest of the people.
But that'll leave a door open someplace.
Yeah, that's right. It better be this door. It's closer to the truck. Before we go out, we'll put some supplies behind the cellar door. While we're gone, the rest of you can hold up in there.
I found some fruit jars in the cellar. And there's a key on here that's labeled for the gas pump out back.
I'm not really that used to the truck. I found it abandoned.
I can handle the truck, no sweat.
You're it, then. You and I'll go. We'll put whatever lumber we find behind the cellar door. You can go upstairs and toss the cocktails from a window. Tom, you and I will have to unboard this door. After you toss the cocktails, you hustle back down here and lock this door. It's no good to board it up because we'll have to get back in quickly. After we get the gas and get back into the house, then we'll worry about getting everybody into the truck. Now let's move it.
Except to the rescue stations which have been set up. Indications are that before this emergency is over, we will need many, many more such rescue stations.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.